Hey everyone, Samantha McDonald, Independent CNC Consultant. Today is another team training video. It is Monday here in Japan, and all of my videos will be posted on Monday, Japan time. So it'll still be around Sunday evening in stateside. So just be on the lookout for those. Once I get back stateside, I'll probably keep it at Mondays if my schedule allots for it. But for now, this is where this is when the team training is going to happen. So today's video is going to be on keeping your sensei business organized and kind of keeping it simple when it comes to running your business. There's so much going on right now at the end of the month. It is the last week of January. And I feel like January just kind of came and now it's leaving and it's crazy. We're getting ready to transition to the new, the new catalog, the new spring catalog. So I'm really looking forward to all of that. But with that, we need to be a little bit more organized because there's going to be so much going on at the beginning. You know, we want to get everyone kind of, we want to host as many parties as we want. We want to get new recruits, especially with the kit, the enhanced kit coming out in February. We really want to get as many people on our team, and we really want to build that PRV, but we also want to be able to do it in a way where it's not completely overwhelming. So to really organize ourselves is the most important thing to do, because if we have a system and a way of doing things that will help us help our business and kind of keep things moving smooth, then, you know, that's pretty much half the battle right there. I am into planning. I always have been, but the planners I've always gotten were kind of like those regular daytime planners, and I never really gave them much thought because I couldn't really write in the spaces. And I don't do the weekly write on the lines because then I'll just be like, yeah, whatever. I do like the calendar format, but I do like the spaces to be bigger. And I never found a planner that was within my budget that did all of that. And then I found a planner called the Happy Planner. And this is the Happy Planner, and it is from, right there, is the 365 Happy Planner. And I love it. This is actually the July 2015 to December 2016 calendar. And the new ones are coming out in February. Very inexpensive. I got this for half off. It was $12 and some change because I got it so late in the year. And newer ones are like $24, $25. And there's really nothing that crazy about them. You know, there's no like crazy extra whistles or, you know, things that you don't need. This is actually a really good basic planner. You know, you have your dates, you have things to remember, things of that nature. I did get the folder inserts because whenever I am going to host parties or, you know, doing something business related, I want to have somewhere to put my receipts. That way I can keep track of exactly what I spent money on and all of that. Especially when I go back to the States, I plan on doing a lot more traveling. So definitely, you know, keeping these. And I mean, it's a really simple planner, but it gets the job done. It really does. And this is the whole entire month of January. And then this is where I'm at in the month. This is where I am at currently. And it's only Monday, and, you know, my calendar still has some space to fill up. But yeah, staying organized. You can write in your calendar, you know, what you're supposed to do for the week. Do you have basket parties going out? Do you have potential hostess meet and greets? Do you have potential recruit meet and greets? Or do you have sip and sniff schedules? To have something written out on your planner, I feel like, is the most important thing, because you can flip through it every single day and say, okay, well, I have this block open, let me do this. And then when you feel like your workload is getting a little bit hectic, find a spot in your planner that is completely open and just use that for yourself. Don't use it for your business. Don't use it for anything else. Use that for yourself. So planning, first step that you absolutely must take to keep your business organized, I think planning. Second of all, when it comes down to making samples or sending out orders to people who have ordered, you want to put it in something. Of course, it's easy to buy the bags from the family store, but let's face it, sometimes we don't always want to go into our workstation and place an order and have to pay for shipping and all that, especially if you live overseas. Shipping is a little bit more expensive, and it's not very cost effective for you. So we have to find different ways. Now, sometimes with bigger orders, they do give us bags in the orders, and that's great. But then sometimes they're a little too big for separate orders. So I went to my Japanese dollar store, which is called the Daiso, and it's just like an American dollar store, I think 10 times better actually. And I got these little white paper bags, these cute little shopping bags. And my bags have to have handles. I have to have handles in my bags. So whenever somebody orders maybe like three or a three pack of bars, six pack of bars, you know, whatever the case may be, I'll put them in these. I save the bigger bags that come into the orders for warmers and things of that nature. But if any of my customers get anything small, I want to put them in one of these. I can put like a host, join, buy, sticker. I can, you know, put whatever I want on here, put a personal touch, staple a flyer of the warmer of the month flyer with a sample on the outside. You know, anything that I can think of. Since it's white, it's, you know, my own canvas, and it's absolutely perfect, and it's kind of like your own personal touch. So there's that. Now, to make samples, of course, we have the sample bags, and like I said, sometimes you just don't have the time for everything to ship out, so you have to do, you know, your own thing. And this is one of the things that I found. They're plastic zipper bags, and they're pretty decent size, and they go a long way. There's 85 of them. There's 85 of these little bags, and they're the perfect sample size. So if you were to use the molds that come in the family store for your samples, I need to open these. I haven't opened them yet. I just bought them today. Ow. So, yeah. And then they come in a bigger bag. That's funny. So yeah, if you were to use the molds that are inside the family store, this is what you would get. So it's a really decent size. And it's perfect because you can put the scent of the month rub and sniff sticker right on the outside. And you don't have to worry about, you know, buying little baggies or whatever. These are actually perfect. You can staple them directly to the flyer. So there's that. So as far as, you know, bagging up orders and bagging up samples, that is completely a wonderful option. That's another way to stay organized, is to make sure that you have enough bags, have enough to give to your clients, because you don't want to get your orders and then put them in a Walmart bag or a grocery store bag. That's like the least professional thing I think anyone can do. And sometimes if you're in a crunch and you don't have anything, I understand, maybe your customers will understand and they'll be like, oh, it's okay. But they'll be like, I got this in a Walmart bag. That's really strange. But there's that. So another way to stay organized is organizing your parties. Not just your home parties or online parties, but your pouch parties if you decide to go that route. I know a lot of people do. I personally haven't really tried any pouch parties here, simply because not a lot of people like to wait for the shipping here. A lot of people like everything on hand, so it's kind of a little bit of a different experience in this place. So if you ever move overseas, you'll see how it works. It's a little strange, but yeah. So if you decide to go the pouch party route, I definitely recommend being a little bit more organized with that. Now, I found these, again, at the local Japanese dollar store, and they're just zippered pouch binders. So, they have this cool little zipper with a little binder, and it opens up, and it's got pockets on either side. And These are absolutely perfect to put your order forms. Whoop, there we go. Order forms on one side. Let me just get those in there. I did not. Whoop, they're not even. Okay, there we go. So order forms fit perfectly. And then this is last spring's catalog. I ran out of the brand new fall catalog, so I'm having to show you my old one. But yeah, they fit in there. Obviously, you won't have as many order forms as I jammed in there, but yeah, they all fit in there. Perfect. Perfect fit on one side. So let's say you do 10 order forms and 3 catalogs, and then on this side, you can put a few testers, a few mini testers in like a Ziploc bag or just in a different type of baggie and put them in here. Then you can also put pens and a few business cards and whatever other brochures that you can think of that can fit in here. Perfect. And it doesn't have, they don't have to stay in the pockets. Some of it can be loose. And so when you close it, that's it. That's perfect. That's all you need. And this would also be great for your mobile office. Have everything in just one little binder and then put it in your tote and away you go, honestly. And you can put like scent packs and travel tins, whatever you need inside of this entire thing, and that'll be your perfect little mobile office. Now, I know a lot of consultants use another direct sales company for their pouch parties. However, I am a stickler for saving money, and since these were at the dollar store, at the Japanese dollar store, these were less than one American dollar a piece. So I got 3, 2 for pouch parties, and then 1 for my mobile office. So yeah, and some other ones that I've seen people use are up to $25. Like I said, I'm a stickler for saving money, and especially when it comes to business supplies, you don't need to spend a lot of money to organize your business in that way. Especially if you're just starting out, if you haven't had the biggest client or customer base that you want, I definitely recommend to, you know, stay within a certain budget. And in case these go missing or somebody takes them, you're not out a whole lot of money, you're just out like a dollar and some change, whatever it costs for you to buy order forms and things of that nature. So organizing your schedule by using a planner. It doesn't have to be anything like this. If you're not a fan of huge planners, if you just want something like a simple day planner, that's totally fine. I need to have some creativity when it comes down to it, or I will be too lazy to even look at a planner. So, of course, I have to go all out and decorate it. I don't go that crazy with it. Like some people I've seen, it's crazy how creative some people can get. I'm just like, yeah, I'm just going to write something in there and call it a day. But yeah, if you're interested in this planner, it is the Happy Planner. And they have different planner. And these are actually removable. And you can put a different cover on there. So that, I mean, that could be a different video in itself. Organizing your samples, organizing your orders, definitely invest in little bags for your samples. They don't have to come from the family store. Nobody's saying that you have to buy them. They're there for your convenience. They have the logos on them, everything already set out for you. So, I mean, if you feel more comfortable that way, that's fine. I like these because you can put the Rub and Sniff sticker right there and you don't have to worry about anything else. That's it. Just, and it's a perfect sample size, so you don't have to, you know, guess. And then of course these little white bags for smaller orders, and I will just buy the bigger bags from the family store because I have yet to find any bags that are what I'm looking for. And then of course organizing your pouch parties or your mobile office with something like this. I will be doing a mobile office video for my team here soon. I just need to get everything organized myself. Like I said, it's January, it's the end of the month. I'm trying to get everything organized in my office, especially trying to figure out what scents are going to be in the new catalog. And of course, we won't find that out just yet. But trying to transition everything, it's going to be a little bit hectic behind the scenes. Yeah, but organization, honestly, that's the most important thing. I can't really think of anything else that would be beneficial as far as organization is concerned. Actually, there are a ton of things, but those would require their own video. Mostly how to organize your order forms after the parties have ended, how to, if they don't have credit cards on them, how to organize your parties, all these things. Those definitely require their own video, but I'm not going to do that today because that's a lot to cover. But this was just like a quick little, you know, what you need to start off with pretty much. I definitely recommend sitting down and making a plan for yourself, figuring out what you're going to do as far as your business. Like, what are you trying to accomplish? Are you a hobbyist? Are you part-time? Are you career? Or are you a kit snapper? Like, do you just want the Scentsy kit and you don't want to really do anything with it? Or you just want to sell to your friends once in a blue moon? You have to figure out what your situation is for yourself, and then that'll determine exactly what you need to get done for your business. What I've personally done is put out a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, days of the week business type of plan. I don't do anything Saturday and Sunday Scentsy related as far as like team training or anything of that nature. If I have to deliver orders and things of that nature, I'll take care of that then, but it's not something that I don't use Saturday and Sunday for Scentsy. I use that for my family. And that's the great part about doing this is that I can choose that. Monday through Friday, though, I do have a breakdown of what I want to do. So mostly Mondays will be team training videos and kind of starting off the week, trying to plan my week. Tuesdays and Fridays on the pages here, on the Facebook pages here for this particular base, you can post your businesses. So I do that on Tuesdays and Fridays, whether it be 9 o'clock in the morning, that's normally the time that I start posting, or right after lunch. It just really depends on the schedules. Wednesdays and Thursdays. Wednesdays is more like I want to do a sit and sniff type of thing because that's a pretty good day for a lot of people. Thursdays will mostly be focused on, you know, hostess coaching and things of that nature. So you really need to sit down, organize your week that way. And, I mean, of course, the planner comes along handy with that because you can see, well, I met with this person on Thursday. Follow up with them next Thursday or follow up with them Tuesday, whenever we discuss following up with each other. But organizing yourself as far as where you are in your business, it really helps determine what you are going to bring to the table and what Scentsy is going to give back to you, essentially. It's really important if you want to make this a career that you start treating this like a career and really start focusing on budgeting yourself. You really, really need to put a budget into your business. You can't just go in and buy every single shiny object that you see in the family store, even though they have all sorts of amazing things. Half the time, you're not going to use most of that stuff. I know in the beginning, I bought a few things that I have yet to use, and I'm just like, I don't know what I'm going to do with it, but it's here, so I don't know. Also, don't just go crazy buying bars and warmers and for displays. If you don't do events, if you don't do anything other than basket parties, you don't need 30 different warmers. You really do not. You really don't. You can have them if you want them, I guess, with your hostess rewards if you throw yourself parties, but you don't need them because then they'll just be sitting there. And bars, if people don't come to you for bars on a regular basis, then, you know, you don't necessarily need to stock up. I would say that if you're just starting out, don't go crazy. Absolutely do not go crazy because you will overwhelm yourself and your budget and your family, and you will just be completely overwhelmed, and it won't do anybody any good. So, you know, take it slow. You know, less is more when it comes to starting out. So, besides organizing your schedule, organizing your samples, your parties, things of that nature, the things that I just broke down and kind of threw at you, those were kind of little tidbits. I will be making videos of different things as the weeks progress, so I definitely want to get into a groove for making more videos for my team. So I really hope that some of this was beneficial in any way, or some of this kind of jumped some gears and kind of started making that hamster wheel turn. Maybe you're going to sit down after this and kind of plan out what you want to do and what you need to get done. You really don't need much to start off, and you really don't need much to have a successful business. You just really need to be organized. Honestly, that is half the battle, and that'll be your, that'll be what makes or breaks you. If you're not organized, you're not going to get anywhere. Honestly, you're just going to have things. That's all you're going to have. You're not going to have organization. You're just going to have things. And I have to be organized. I don't know about you, but I absolutely have to be organized. So, all right. If you have any more, any questions, any of my team has any questions, please let me know what type of videos you would like for me to make for you. Like I said, I'll be making more videos, mostly about organizing my mobile office, maybe how I plan my days, things like that. But for now, this was just kind of a, you know, little idea tosser in there. So, all right, I hope everybody has enjoyed their January. I really cannot wait for February, because that is going to be the fun month. And then after that is March, which is the new spring catalog, and I don't know about you, but I'm completely over the winter scents already, so I kind of want some spring in there. Alright, I hope everyone has a wonderful, rest of the week. Enjoy your Monday. Yeah, have a good day, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.